right, Mrs. Hendricks, you take care, and I'll see you tomorrow afternoon. Dr. Rogers? Yes? What?
Skipped hand hygiene, Dr. Rogers.
Oh, come on.
Add 20 seconds to the clock, repeat hand hygiene.
Wow, did you see that, Jessica? Dr. Rogers clearly skipped hand hygiene.
A classic unforced error, Frank, and it's going to cost him and his patients.
No doubt, Jessica. Welcome back, folks. We'll take a close look at that play and our top three goofs of the week coming up next on Germ Center. Well, folks, we had some spectacular plays this week and some real goofs. Let's get back to Dr. Rogers and really break it down.
Frank, it's easy to forget the importance of hand hygiene, isn't it? Let's go to the replay.
Oh, classic mistake, Jessica. He reaches for the dispenser and gets distracted by his cell phone.
A real humdinger, Frank, and that could lead to some very bad news. I think maybe it comes down to a big error in the coaching. He just doesn't see the risk. No question that was a penalty, but let's hear what the good doctor has to say about it.
Thanks, Jessica. Hey, Doc, so what do you think went wrong?
Honestly, I just didn't keep my head in the game. Too many distractions, moving too fast.
Gonna do anything different in the second half?
Oh, absolutely. I really need to get back to the basics. Hand hygiene 101, right? Come to think of it, I should probably disinfect my phone now, too.
Back to you.
All right, best of luck to Dr. Rogers, and I've got another one for you, Frank.
You feeling okay? Hey, we're just gonna check that wound for you, okay? All righty. Woo. Yeah, we're gonna have to, let me just make honey. All right, okay, let's take one more peek.
Gloves are no substitute for proper hand hygiene.
Oh, no, that's a big one.
Gloves are not magic, are they, Frank?
They are not. Gloves absolutely should not make up for poor hand hygiene. It should be hand hygiene, gloves on, gloves off, hand hygiene.
And in this case, there were actually two penalties. Not performing hand hygiene before putting on her gloves, and again, after touching the patient, she didn't remove and dispose of her gloves and perform hand hygiene prior to touching the keyboard.
Yep, classic germ-spreading behaviors. All right, we've got another one. Let's get back to Fairview General.
What?
Incomplete hand washing. Repeat the play.
You're right.
Soap and water is the right idea, not like that.
What an easy call that was to make. He really should be in there for at least 15 to 20 seconds. Improper hand hygiene? Contaminated hands. It's as simple as that. But you know, Frank, the news isn't all bad. Let's take a look at a real star player this week. Let's meet Amy Montana.
Okay, Mrs. Smith, that looks really good. How do you feel? Okay, good. Well, I'll be back to check on you a little bit later, okay?
An inconvenient hand hygiene station, Frank, can you believe it? It gets them every time. It's a real downer when it comes to hand hygiene to not have easy access. But Amy didn't let that get to her. No sorry, Frank.
Touchdown.
Let's head down to the field, or hospital.
Great job there, Amy. How'd you do it?
Persistence and good training. There are a lot of opportunities for hand hygiene. It could be 100 times a day, but it never gets old. Muscle memory is what it takes. I'd like to thank my coaches, my parents, of course, and everyone who got me here.
No doubt, Amy, no doubt.
I mean, really, how hard is it, right? I don't want germy hands, and I don't want to make my patients or my coworkers sick, or worse.
Back to you.
Amy went the extra mile, literally, to perform hand hygiene. Well done, Amy.
What a great story, Jessica. Really inspiring. But we're gonna take a little time out here. We'll be right back.
It's been tough out there today. But when the job is done, it's time for hand hygiene. We're talking about a deep down scrub. The fingertips, the nails, even between your fingers and around your thumb. You're doing it all. Hand hygiene for healthcare professionals everywhere. Failure to use proper hand hygiene may cause illness, diarrhea, or death.
I love taking those refreshing hand hygiene breaks, Jessica.
Me too, Frank. Best way to stay sharp and healthy. But looking back at all of those empty and broken hand sanitizing dispensers that Amy had to go through, hard to watch, isn't it, Frank?
Yeah, this is something we are seeing happening way too often. But don't drop your sanitizer bottles, folks. We've got another star player of the week, CNA Travis. Let's see how this seasoned athlete helps turn around the team.
No, not on my watch.
Hey, could you put in a work ticket for the broken dispenser outside room 2288?
Wow, that's a new record.
He's impressive, Frank, but let's put it into perspective. In a short time, he's potentially saving lives by ensuring everyone has easy access to clean hands.
All righty, folks, it's the segment we've all been waiting for, this week's top three gaffes. Let's get right to it.
At number three, Rebecca Rivera skips hand hygiene and high-fives her coworker. That's a germ spreader.
And at number two, the door handle. Big germ spreader there. That thing is filthy.
That's right, Frank. Dr. Manning has grabbed that door handle, skipped hand hygiene, and now she's touched her patients.
And at numero uno this week, Dr. Turner skips hand hygiene and grabs a coffee pot in the break room. Oh, what a disaster. 15-yard penalty, red card, ejected from the game. I mean, come on.
Ah, the kinds of things we don't think twice about take on a whole new meaning in the healthcare setting.
No doubt. Germs spreading through hands by touching and by sharing of objects and by improper hand hygiene, it's common, but unacceptable.
Stopping the spread of germs needs to become second nature for everyone, especially if you're in the healthcare field.
Yep. Well, that's all the time we have for today. We'll see you next week on Germ Center.